Welcome to Creation Process. Today we're going to make a cell, human cell, one healthy and one bad. So let's begin. We'll be using 3D Max for that. So first we'll make a sphere. We have to increase the segments around 100. Now we will go to modify and add three modifiers. That's one of them is noise, stretch, and last one, squeeze. Okay, so first we're using a noise. We will distort his shape, its shape. So let's start 5 by 5 by 5. So see the shape, it's not what it is. Now we will adjust my scale. See from side views how the shape is getting distorted. Let's distort a little. Okay. Now, using this squeeze, we'll squeeze it from the top. A bit of noise, we should reduce this a little bit. And keep this seat 0. Just adjust with this scale. And this squeeze, we reduce this a little bit. Okay. Now, the stretch, we'll stretch a little bit. Done. A little bit more. Okay. So after this, next step is to make a material. So press M for that, and we'll choose this. We'll be doing using VR material. So first, take a viral material. Yeah, it's all the viral material. So what are the basic parameters? And diffuse, we'll add fall off, and on top we'll choose red color, dark red. And this one, the light. And that's all for this. We'll go back to the main. And here we will add some maps in bump and displacement. So in the bump, we'll add noise. Where is the noise? Yeah. And you'll see after adding the noise, the shape has changed a bit. It's quite big, so we'll reduce the shape. It's 25, so we'll put 1. It's not visible from here, but it has an effect. We'll see it later. And after this, we'll go back. I will put some displacement map, which will be noise. Yeah, noise. And yeah, now you'll see this is so huge, so we'll reduce it to 5. Okay, now let's apply this stuff. line. Let's try to render it out. Okay. We need a light for this. So we will take a V-Ray light. V-Ray light. And we'll use ambient light. Put it over here. And modifier, we will be changing the color from black to white so that the light has its effect. And let's try to render it out how it's look. Yeah, now it's better. So next, you'll see that the bump is too high, displacement is too large, so we'll reduce it from outside here. It's 100, so we'll reduce it to 10. And let's check the render. Okay, so render is done. You see that it's had a good effect in us. This depth has come up, it's good. So next step, what we'll be doing is we'll be adding some glossiness above it. So we'll just give some reflection to that around 10. And just give some glossiness, 0.80. You see that, yeah, it has come out. Let's try to render it out. Slowly the rendering speed will be getting a little bit slower, because as we add more and more maps, the file get heavier. But with that, the output get better and better. So now, it's good, but some few details are missing. That's due to lack of light. So we're adding one more light, which will be giving some specular effect. So in the modem, we'll be taking this. We'll take a photometric light and free light. Okay, this will give us good effect. So in this, we'll go to modifier and we will just shut off the point uniform on. Okay, let's try to render how slow. Oh, it's a totally different view. We have to select this view and select render. So it seems the light has a great intensity, but see, you can see that there is a specular effect on the top, so it's nice. So we need is, we have to take it aside. Let's see, where is it? Okay. Sometimes in the perspective view, you have to go and see where you're putting a light. And we will reduce the intensity here. Fine, where is the intensity? Okay. We have to remove the diffuse and just keep the specular, and let's see what effect it comes up. Just set the camera object. And let's render. yeah, it's nice. So now the specular effect is on top. We need some reflection from here so that it feels like 3D and realistic. So we'll put one more light. We'll just copy this. Shift and duplicator. Copy. Okay. Now we put this on the downside. Back side of it. And let's see the impact. Let me see whether I have put it in the correct place. We'll just move it forward a little bit so that it's visible. Now using this, you can zoom in and zoom out. Okay, now render. So we have made a healthy cell. Next step is we'll be making a bad cell. That's a so we'll take another, we'll just drag and drop it over here, and we'll go to diffuse. I'll just change the red color to some pale color, which will be like sicky color. Sick. Green is good, but if we change it to green and yellow, it's become pale, which means it's like dead. Yeah, it's dead. It means dead color. When something dies, the colors turn to pale. You might see in that. In various movies, we see the human, when a human is dead, its skin turns into pale color. And we, like zombies and all, their skin color is like, not your skin, but it's like dead color, like this. We apply it over here, and in here, we will apply a pale color with lightness, with, yeah, bright color. Bright pale, and we'll just check it out there. We'll just apply this over here, and this assigning material asks we want to replace it or rename this material. So we'll just rename it because we don't want to replace it. Rename this because we will be applying some new stuff later. So let's make this dead cell. Let's see the render. Render is good, but I think it's very dark. I must change the just little brighten the green color, pale one, and let's see how it's affecting rendering. Some kind of depth is missing, I think. Wait, let's little bit darker, and this little bit more, little green, yeah. And okay, so next step, what we will be needing is in the dead cell, we'll be changing few stuffs. So this is okay, this is okay. Here in the displacement, we will be removing this map. So by clicking in on and dragging on it, you can remove this stuff. And after that, you will apply a cellular, because this is an organism. So